Missing is a gripping and suspenseful thriller that keeps audiences on the edge of their seats from start to finish, directed by John Harper and released in 2023. If you are not watching this show, then you are probably missing it. Anyway, audiences gave this show rating a 4 out of 5 score. For a show where filming revolves around with phone and webcam, it is pretty good. It is a commendable film that delivers a captivating storyline, strong performances, and a skillfully executed mystery. It keeps viewers engaged throughout, offering an intense and emotional journey. If you enjoy psychological thrillers that keep you guessing until the very end, Missing is definitely worth watching. However, this show is currently available in the US region on Netflix, so, if you are unable to watch it or is a broke soul who could not afford one, we got you covered. The next part is the plot summary. Spoilers alert. The show started off with an archive video where you see the main character, named June at 6-year-old with her dad. Her dad had a nosebleed and it is due to brain tumors, not because he got punched in the face. Or is it? She then began trimming the sad part of the video after 10 years. Took her long enough. Anyway, her mom, Grace, finally found a new soulmate and the dude is an awkward Asian. Please go and shave those facial hair. They got on the Uber and drove off for vacation in Colombia for a week. So what do most teenagers do when parents not at home for a week? Party. Anyway, her irresponsible friends ended up leaving a mess after the party and did not help her to clean up. Then she had a reminder to pick up her mom from the trip at the airport. She waited and waited and no one shows up. Knowing that her mom went missing, she filed in police report and trace her mom through her visited locations. Realizing something is off after talking to the hotel receptionist, she hires Javier, a Colombian gig worker who complies with June's requests to find her missing mom for a small fee. From a house cleaner to an undercover agent. This guy has gone places. Since he has a low rating for a housekeeper, it's time for him to switch job. June then start hacking into email accounts and other bunch of stuff with half of the time resetting the passwords to track her mom. No, not this time. But still, I think she has a bright future ahead to work as a hacker or detective. Moving on, she discovered that the Asian guy, Kevin, has a number of aliases and a criminal record of scamming many women for their money. Kevin, you are a disgrace to the Asian society. Our ancestors are disappointed in you.
Emotional damage!
She also finds him dating another woman. That woman is not her mother, by the way. Believing Kevin to have kidnapped her mother, June has Javier look for clues as to their whereabouts in Colombia. She traces Kevin's past movements to a location in Nevada, met a church priest named Jimmy and tracked the stores where Kevin purchases a key lock chain. It is for the Love Bridge nearby and through Google footage, she saw Kevin proposes to her mom. How sweet. Suddenly the FBI agent Park informs June that he received footage of a band of criminals seemingly kidnapping Kevin and her mom in Colombia. After digging deeper, June unmasks that the woman that was on the plane flying to Colombia was not her mother. It was actually the other chick that looks like her mom, but not her mom. Thus, the FBI discovered that Kevin had hired a look-alike actress named Rachel Page to impersonate her mother. Her mother had already been kidnapped before going to the airport. This unique case makes a national headlines and people start making the search around Los Angeles. June once again hack into a private chat app and her suspicions fall on Heather, one of her mother's trusted companion. When she discovers an encrypted line of communication between her and Kevin, June sneaks into Heather's office but finds it ransacked and with files deleted. So, it's either she ran away or someone killed her. Her dead body is found at the corner of the storeroom. Later, June views live footage of a police raid in Colombia focusing on Kevin, who is shot and killed despite surrendering. Seemingly at a dead end, June is about to give up but manages to access her mother's email. She finds a threatening email directed at Grace, which leads her to discover security cameras that Kevin bought were installed at an abandoned house, which happens to be her old family trip video. Jimmy, the priest guy called and arrives in front of June's house and reveals that he is June's dead father. Her face looks so done and so am I. He claims that Grace was emotionally unstable and took June away from him after having him arrested under false charges. However, when he unwittingly reveals he was in the same prison with Kevin, it is later revealed that James was a domestic abuser whose drug habit endangered all of them. Grace and Heather had told June he died of cancer to shield her from the truth. James sought revenge by enlisting Kevin, whom he met in prison, to pose as a prospective boyfriend so he could find Grace and June. June tried to answer her friend's call for help but got her ass dragged away by his dad and tied up on the chair. James kidnaps June and takes her to the old house, where Grace is also detained. They finally got reunited, but then Grace got shot by James. Then James tries to tie up June. We can tell that at this point, this guy is into bondage genre, but Grace says she hates that genre and stabs him in the neck with a shard of broken glass. Then her mom fell back down and her dad got up. He tried to find nearby hospital, but this time, he is pronounced dead. Like finally. June, realizing James never shut off her laptop when he kidnapped her, uses the cameras to tell Siri to call the police. Thank God her computer did not go on sleep mode. The police come into the rescue and...
30 squads of control, we have an adult female, upper body GSW, Chaganty, Maryland.
I didn't know this Netflix show was sponsored by another Netflix show. Several months later, Grace has survived her gunshot wound, and June is in college. Their story has been adapted on the true crime show Unfiction, and Grace has started a friendship with Javier after June introduced them. June texts her mother that she loves her, and Grace responds that she loves her too. The end.